Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about diffusion versus sound redirection. Completely different principles, completely different sound, and much confusion about this. A lot of sound redirection devices in the marketplace are called sound diffusers, and it's simply not true, and let's find out why. Let's look at some definitions first. Five conditions in a room before you have a diffuse sound field. There are five clearly defined conditions that must be present in your room before you can actually say you have a diffused sound field within your room. 99.9% of the rooms I'm in, not there. Missing one or two or three of these five things, and we'll get into those shortly. Sound redirection, let's define that. Redirection is sound energy striking a surface and then reflecting back in the opposite direction. Angle of incident equals angle of refraction or reflection. So, not the same principle, not the same end result in a room. Definitely not contributing in a few situations, and in many situations sometimes, to a diffuse sound field in a room. So let's look at the five conditions that we must have present in our room in order to call our room a diffused sound field situation within our room. So let's look at the five things that we need. All right, let's look at the five conditions that must be present in a room before we can actually say we have good diffusion within our room. We have what's called a diffuse sound field. So let's look at those five conditions. The first one, we have no frequency or spatial irregularities in the frequency response. No big peaks, no big dips, plus or minus 2 dB, plus or minus 1.5 dB. Nice tight peaks and troughs, smooth, no spatial irregularities. The second one, the beats and the decay characteristic of our room must be negligible. On a log scale, and we'll get into that in another video, but it must be a straight line on a log scale. So we have to have the beats and the decay characteristic negligible, not noticeable at all. Third, the decays must be exponentially perfect. You know, we can't have big pauses and hiccups in the curve, so they must be exponentially perfect, and we must make sure that that's the case. The fourth characteristic, the decay characteristics, must be the same every place in the room. Can't have one room with a higher decay or lower decay rate than the other one. And finally, the reverb time. The reverb time must be the same in all parts of the room. Now, these are the five criteria that you must have within your room in order to have what's called a diffused sound field within your room. How do you get these five characteristics? Well, you use devices that are sound diffusion devices and not sound redirectional devices. And let's look at the differences. Okay, here we have an example of sound diffusion versus sound redirection. This is our diffuser QRD Series 7 based on prime number 7. So we'll use that as our prop here. We've all seen these sound direction devices. They're hemispherically shaped. They're half rounds, they're tubes, they're things along that line that they have this. So sound energy comes in at a certain angle, leaves at the opposite angle. So that's the function, that's how they work. Well, we know that a sound diffuser works completely different. It has a series of wells or troughs, different frequencies. The energy enters the wells, comes out in a fan-like array, not reduced in time or amplitude. So completely different approach, really true sound diffusion, and that's what we really need to have to contribute to those characteristics. So a sound redirectional device, when they're put next to each other in a room, really don't have a lot of diffusion or a lot of sound redirection even below 300 cycles. So they're limited in bandwidth, so to speak, and also just the basic way that they perform is limiting. So it's difficult with a sound redirectional device to get a true sound diffuse sound field in your room because of just the nature of the elements. Manufacturers call them sound diffusers because they want you to believe that they have a diffuser in their product line, And technically they don't, because it can't satisfy those five conditions that we went over. So let me see if I can kind of put this to the side. And let's look at no frequency or spatial irregularities. Would a sound redirectional device accomplish that? Maybe. But since it doesn't work really well below 300 cycles, we probably would have some issues in that range. Beats in the decay characteristic negligible. Well, if there's a spatial irregularity in the frequency response of the unit itself, you're going to have difficulties with that. You're going to have difficulties having an exponentially same decay rate. So reverb time and decay characteristics in the room must be met, and the device must be able to contribute to that. So the only diffusion device that we have found that really works well is the quadratic diffuser, because it can provide you with diffusion in two dimensions. A vertically positioned diffuser can diffuse sound in a horizontal dimension, and a horizontally positioned diffuser can diffuse sound in a vertical direction. So you really can get two of possible three dimensions of sound with one device. For us, as designers and builders and acoustic people that are trying to create certain things in the inside of the room, it's a great tool because it's so versatile. You can even choose the frequency response. Thank you.